Hello viewers, and welcome back to Mezari on Endless. Same settings as last time, right? We're gonna just do the same thing. You'll notice I'm keeping the Morgar and the Alai in, Islands map. Going for a naval focus game. So somebody pointed out in the comments of the beginning of the last game that actually the Morgar and the Alai probably don't conquer the sea regions any more effectively than anybody else. I was thinking because they start the game with the ability to get units out on the water, they can do quests, and not remembering that the AI does not do quests. So that person was 100% right. Any conquering of sea regions that the AI does will be done with boarding vessels, and everybody gets boarding vessels at the same speed. I don't know, does the AI search ruins? Because actually, it's possible that the Morgar or Lai will get the boarding vessel design slightly quicker by searching ruins, because you can sometimes find that design in sea ruins. But, that aside, yeah, all of the AI region, all of the AI empires should get out onto the water, or should get sea conquering done at about the same speed. But the Morgar and the Lai are a little bit more likely to take over territory that's not on their initial starting landmass, as we saw last game. So I'm gonna keep them in the game for that purpose. Okay, so we got sort of a mud hole stomped into us that last game. That was a little rough. What did we learn? Well, number one, we learned that, what do we start with here? Bos. That's fine, not exciting. Number one, we learned that it's dangerous to go halfway as far as the ocean goes. We gotta commit. What do we have over here? So that's gonna be my plan this game, is to really, like, don't just send a single boat out. Keep building boats. Get a navy that's capable of fighting the minor factions. Secure some naval borders as quickly as possible. If we can get even one ocean region secured, it's going to be such a big help. I do not like our starting position here. Let's send the hero off this way. Reveal the tiles over here. We have access to a couple of anomalies, but like this is some low industry. Alright, so maybe we want to settle over in this region. We want ocean access pretty quickly. It doesn't have to be right away, but it should be within one borough, hopefully. We gotta find 13833 is not... That's not terrible. It's not awesome. That's okay. We gotta be able to win when it's not awesome. So this is 13610-2. You gotta remember, as vaulters, we're strongly incentivized to settle where there's food. Or where there's science, rather. Because science tiles are... Tiles that have science on them have one extra point of resource, as far as we're concerned. So I think it's gonna be right here. We're sacrificing two industry for seven science, basically. I think that's probably the right play. We can just hope to get lucky with ruins, get some early dust, get some of our early buildings purchased, and make up the difference. Okay. I think this is probably fairly uncontroversial. It does put an extra turn on our first berth, but I think it's not a big deal. Six turns to Founders Memorial is, grim. It's alright, we're gonna be okay. So... Another thing is we have to get a functioning army going, like, a lot earlier. Alright, we're going to research Language Square first, and then Mill Foundry, as usual. We don't need a Mill Foundry in three turns, we won't be ready for it in three turns, so we may as well get our parlay on. We could still get lucky with, we could still get lucky with Minor Faction Quest too. Alright, so I would expect us to be on an island that is about four regions. Played a couple of games on the islands map type before, and it seems like they usually give you about four regions. Which should be pretty much ours for the taking. Okay, 40 dust. Not so lucky so far with the ruins, obviously. So after we get the mill foundry up... We have to start thinking about the water. I am noticing a serious lack of industry. Don't care for that. Okay, here we go. We have some industry anomalies down here. This actually looks like a pretty okay settling location. Right here, we have only 6 industry, but look at the raw number of points of resources. It's pretty fantastic. All right, some pretty normal dust. We'll stop here so that we can parlay with this village at the beginning of the next turn. What do we have here? Dorgeshi. Dorgeshi are fine. They're not bad troops. Remember, the first step of our faction quest is to pacify and assimilate a minor faction, so that should be fairly easy. It does mean that we're going to assimilate earlier than we normally would, probably. Be the first to activate 4 luxury boosters in order to get 130 gold is our first legendary deed, and pacify 8 villages. Okay, we have a chance on this. We could do this. You'll notice we're in third right now. I believe player wins ties, so I think that means that the 2 of the other factions have already burned down a minor faction village. Alright, so we'll talk to the boss. We are going to be hard-pressed to take these villages out through violence, I think. We don't have particularly tough troops, and we've seen cavalry as minor factions. Actually, I guess I could have just had this guy run, because this guy is going to be in range to, Yeah, I wasn't thinking about all my options there. Destroy a Dorgeshi village. Okay, so now I can no longer parlay with these guys. Because once you have a quest to destroy a village, you can't talk to them anymore. Ooh, look at this! Okay, so there's 2 strong anomalies here and 2 strong anomalies here. We could build... we could start this city here, and the first expansion gets us a ton of extra resource points. This is actually a really strong region in total. Oops, just clicking too much. I'm so excited about the prospect of talking to some Dorgeshi. Alright, that's not awesome. Where are all the easy quests, man? Okay. We should probably try to merge up. We can cut the hemorrhaging a little bit. 60 dust. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to buy this out. The benefit of having your Founders Memorial up soon really cannot be overstated. I probably could have bought it out last turn, actually. Okay, we are not having extraordinary luck with quests or with ruins so far. Looks like we might be at the bottom of the map. Okay, 40 dust is fine. But with some factions, you only want to find dust. I don't feel that we really are one of those factions. Okay, I think we can probably snap the hero to this army at this point. That'll cut down on our army maintenance costs, since we're now running 2 armies instead of 3. We can finish exploring this. Okay, it looks like a lot of our non-home regions have way better resource support. Okay, we'll get some free influence eventually. Like, this is a cool settling location right here. It's pretty low science, but these are Earth Tower and Standing Stones, sorry, Mineral Rich, are both strong anomalies. What have we found here? Eyeless ones. Okay, well, these guys will be easy enough to take down in combat, if it comes to that. So we know roughly where we want to put our next couple of cities. I guess I don't know where in Neth I want to put a city yet. Do I want to talk to the village or hit that ruin first? I think we're going to talk to the village. It looks like we have a larger island this time. More regions. It's possible that that means that maybe we're sharing a landmass with another player, or maybe we just got 5 regions. It's a little bit of luck. Luck or the game remembering the last session and taking pity on us. I'll accept either. Oh, Kazanji. Okay, I'm gonna hope that we can get this quest done, because I do not love fighting Kazanji with low HP units. So, traditionally at this point, I would go Empire Mint, because dust is really, really important. Yeah, we have to build a burrow before we can make boats anyway. After we get our mill foundry up, we'll burrow out to this tile. And then we'll start boating. Alright. Well, we got a couple of ruins here. Let's find some magic. 30 dust? That's even worse than what we've been finding. And nothing. Okay. Well. Whew. This is going to be maybe not a trivial quest. Okay, well, we've got a couple of anomalies down here. We could settle between the anomalies and accept that we have a dead tile, or maybe between this anomaly and the river with the intent of building into the river. I don't know. We certainly have a lot of things that we need to build in Hylaman. Our rate of science is a little lower than I would like. I wanted to get that library finished pretty quickly. In 2 turns, we'll have another birth, which I think will take a turn off the mill foundry. So we'll go from 16 to 20. We'll have already dropped it to 59. So, yeah. Okay, so the mill foundry will actually be done in 4 turns. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see about the cost of a burrow. It may not be feasible to get out quite as quick as I was hoping. You know, we gotta adjust to the circumstances of each individual game. So we're probably going to be moving the hero back to the city for temporary governance after the opening phase here. But remember, Avar Lasmek is going to be a general, not a governor. I guess let's look this way. Okay, so one thing I actually have not been paying a tremendous amount of attention to, and it probably behooves me to fix that, is where are my strategics? So we have glass steel in our home region, titanium and lice, glass steel in Neth, it looks like nothing in Valdea, and then down here in, what is this, Gomji? I can't see exactly what character I'm standing on there. It might be Gom. No, that's an L. I don't know, whatever. This region has some tiles unrevealed yet, so maybe something. So we probably want to get Lais next, which was going to be the case anyway, due to proximity and the clustering of anomalies. And this is maybe going to be more of an inland region. It may not have a dock. Okay. We're bleeding dust again, slowly, due to the buildings that we've constructed, and the fact that they have upkeep costs. It's okay, we'll be merging these two forces together in a second here. Alright, what is our quest in this region? Build a coastal battery in less than 5 turns. I hate this quest. I don't think it's supposed to be coastal battery all the time. I think it's supposed to be, you know, a random building. It might be that it's supposed to be like the building that you have access to that has the highest cost or something, and it ends up being the coastal battery because the coastal battery is sort of an advanced building. But the problem with the coastal battery is that it costs adamantium, which you are definitely not going to have at this point in the game. So the Ursus often give you an uncompletable quest. Alright, yeah, let's merge up. Stop the dust hemorrhage. Alright, so do I need to get ships next? I think this is an okay time to veer off and get ships. Our cities have stuff to build. Our city, singular, has stuff to build. We don't need research to unlock a new building because we won't be short on stuff to do for a while yet. Okay, So once we have our mill foundry up, I think it is time to consider the burrow. Oh, somebody hit era 2. It took them all the way till turn 13. AI's losing their touch, man. Okay, so Gulji has titanium. And as far as luxury deposits go, we have a single die deposit on our entire landmass. So let's not place a lot of emphasis on getting the luxury extractors up. I'm going to get the Empire Mint first. My thinking there is just that we desperately, desperately need real income. And honestly, with our city still being as busy as it is, I think we're probably going to research the mercenary market next. Because we still are in a position where we don't really have free building time. And this is something that we don't have to devote build time to take advantage of. Alright, so this is the only village that we can, like, really trivially destroy. But I don't even want to, because this is the village that gave us a relatively easy high reward quest. So I'm going to try to head over to Lais and see if we can't blow up this village. If we can, we'll get the pacification here plus a little reward. I think it's definitely the case that we are not getting tactical training this game. We just pulled a bad set of quests, and somebody's going to have burned down 8 villages before we can. It's okay, it's not the end of the world. Technical training is nice to have, but it's by no means necessary. Okay, Empire Mint is up. We did not find any luxury resources yet. Sometimes you find some in a ruin, sometimes you have to get them through minor faction quests. And yeah, I know I'm slowing our roll here on the first expansion. We're gonna get our first city, or our second city, a little slower than I like to. I'd like to try to found on turn 20 if possible, right after dropping the Empire plan. But if we can get even one C region, I think that it's worth it. All right, we can do this. Dorgeshi Burdeki are scary to fight with ranged units. And we don't have a lot of great terrain, although they started down the cliff, which is cool. They have 4 movement, 5 movement, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So we need to start, like, way back here. Alright. You move to the high ground and into the forest. He's gonna move 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll be able to hit him if we back up. I'm trying to spread out a little bit so that if it gets adjacent to us, it's not providing minus morale to everybody. Because ranged units do not like to have enemy units adjacent to them. Alright. Well, he moved a little differently than I thought he would. We can still hit him with 2 of our units, but not all of them. Alright, well, here's where it gets ugly. Alright, the forest is helping a little bit. Okay, only 1 stun went off. That's good. We might lose. Ooh! A no damage attack is good for us. We might not lose anybody this battle. I was gonna say we might lose 1 Marine, but it's looking pretty good for us. Okay, I think that was about the best we could have hoped for. Alright, so 15 glass steel, and we'll get some emeralds from bringing this back. And then we can turn in that glass steel for pacification on another region, right? Somebody wanted glass steel. The Dugeshi. Okay. Alright, well, this will get us another population point in Hyloman. We could, instead of turning in the glass steel, we could pop it to give us a boost. We're going to use the emeralds, because doing so will push us over the happiness barrier and get us plus 15. And now, we don't want to do it right this second, but now we have a faction that we can assimilate to move our faction quest forward. Would I rather have titanium or glass steel running as my first booster? Because actually, we could turn in the glass steel and then use the titanium from this. Yeah, let's turn in the glass steel. I think I want titanium running in the early game. Okay. So we're only two techs out from leveling up here. I think I'm going to make it these. Alchemist Furnace, obviously. We need resources. And topography is just great. I know we haven't picked up cultivation yet. We'll come back for it. We'll get it sometime during Era 2. We have a lot of things we need to build. Alright, have these guys put out an army yet? It doesn't look like it. We may be able to pacify this region before they build their first army. Which would be nice for us, not having to deal with that. Okay. Whew. Made some friends, we have some money. How expensive is a hero right now? We have this pretty early. So we're not too far off of being able to purchase a real governor. What do we have access to? Fire Spike. Expansion Support 2 is not that great. Ozek the Chosen is Influence Boost 3 and a Cultist Hero. It's pretty hard to argue with for your first city. That might be the one. So we're looking at 320. Probably we will not be able to buy this the turn we hit 320 because it'll be more expensive by then. But if we save up on dust, these are only 196. You know, maybe we don't need to push for an early governor. Maybe we should push for an early navy. The other question is, do I want to upgrade? Yeah, I think I do. I think I do want to at least give them the Fomorian Slayer thing, even though that raises their cost by more than 50%, because it causes them to do 30% extra damage in combat. Boats are Fomorian units. Almost all naval units are Fomorian units. So 3 turns or 341. We gotta get a settler out at some point here. It's probably better to make the settler first. We're delaying things by a lot here. Are we actually right exactly our food? Ugh. But that's before we expanded. Hold on, it may not have adjusted the, oh no, it did. I was gonna say, it may not have adjusted the payouts based on the fact that we claimed extra tiles, but no, it totally did. Alright. Let's rush the settler, get the boats, and I think this is the point where we can afford to pull the hero into the city. Well, are we going to try to pacify any of the other minor factions through force? I think the answer to that question is no. Right, it's Ursus and Kazanji that we might have to do it to. I don't really want to fight Kazanji with just archers, with just two archers anyway. I don't really need to fight these Ursus, and we're going to pacify this region through questing to get the rewards. So yeah, we can pull the hero back to the city and temporarily take advantage of Science Boost 2. Yeah, it's a good amount of science. Okay. So we're not too far behind. What is this? This army really has very little to do. I think we're going to go over to here, just to get vision. If the Eyeless Ones have spawned an army, it should not be a problem for two Marines to deal with, I think. Eyeless Ones are pretty bad at combat. Oh, never mind. Turn around. Pearls. It's pearl time. I saw a couple of deposits spawn over here before our vision rolled back. Alright, keep taking governor skills. And let's get that settlement. I don't think there's any competition for locations. This is very clearly the place. It's a little food light. We'll be fine. The first burrow will solve that problem. Alright, now that we know where we're settling, we can turn off the resource overlay. So we gotta get some pearls. I'd like to get 10 pearls off of this winter. Shouldn't be a problem. There's no nobody contesting them on our landmass. That was 5, this is 4. We only have to find one more deposit. Alright. I would love it if this winter was really short. This would be a great winter to be short. Once we have our first vessel out, we'll start questing and stuff immediately. But we're going to keep making ships because we need to get the ability to fight minor faction navies. Turn 26. It's not too bad for Aaron, too. It's not awesome. And that was the turn that we crossed the threshold. So we could take Bos as an assimilate. Plus 5% food is not bad. But we only have the one village, and they're not bad units. Free counter is pretty good. I think that the Durgeshi are better units. If you plan to use your cavalry sort of as like a skirmisher, Bos are way better at just fighting infantry than a lot of cavalry units are, and there's definitely something to be said for that. Yeah, let's go ahead and assimilate them. We need food anyway. The Durgeshi assimilation bonus is, I think, just a little bit of a combat stat. It's not super, super relevant. Alright, so where do I think... about over here. Anomalies often spawn pearls. Let's check all of the anomalies in the area. Oh, yeah. I was going to do this. You know, I researched boarding vessels, but maybe it's better not to do that. Maybe it's better to research stuff in Era 1. Since we're not really getting ships out that early, maybe I should just go straight to fire ships. I don't know. We haven't done it, but maybe that's a good idea next time. So what are we going to start research on? Actually, you know what? Let's pick up cultivation before we start picking up things that have strategic resource costs. How is our dust situation here? Are we... okay, it's not going to be too bad once winter ends. Which could maybe be right now? Wouldn't that be great? No? Okay. Alright, 15 titanium. Let's go ahead and spend the booster now. Because I don't want to pay 15 if we can pay 10. In case you're not aware, it is based on the number of cities you have, so... alright. That's 8 pearls spawned in a single winter? That's crazy. Yeah, food and dust light until the winter ends. Let's just get the basics going here. We actually need to get this up pretty quickly. I'm even going to prioritize this over the Empire Mint. Alright, we're about to have our first ship. It is turn 27. It's a little later than I might like. Okay, no pearls. That's fine. Oh, we have a holy booster going. We can just teleport them. That pearl cluster a lot faster. Okay, with winter being over... this took a surprisingly long time, actually. I think the AI usually completes this quite a bit faster. It may have something to do with the way the units are constrained by the islands. Okay, I want to search this ruin, obviously, but we also want to try to find our nearby fortresses quickly and get quests from them. It's taking us a really long time to build ships. Oh, our booster ran out. We're back down to content. Or no, our booster didn't run out. It's just found in the second city pulled us down to content. Now the booster ran out. Are we actually... No, okay, we're... The booster ran out, but we're not unhappy. Alright, well, we need a couple of things here. We should probably pick up Central Markets. We want to boost our approval quickly. We have enough glass steel left over to build a couple of these. Should I try to attack this guy now while he's near the city? We might be able to... It's so hard to keep flying units off of your archers, though. Oh, there's lightning on that tile right now, actually. I'm not in a hurry. Not in a hurry to sail into the lightning storm. Let's grab these pearls, wait for it to pass. So our next faction quest step is build strategic resource extractors, which obviously we're working on. Well, we will be working on. I don't know how we're going to find time for all this stuff. If only we had more dust. Oh, that's right. It's luxury resource extraction is the assimilation bonus. So actually, the Dorgeshi bonus is quite good. Sometimes for some people. Not so great for us. I forgot to turn off my Steam friends list. Sorry about that. Okay, I usually go into offline mode for recording. So the weather is going to drift one space to the east, and this is still going to be in a lightning storm. Oh no, it looks like it may have drifted two spaces to the east. Okay. Well, we can search this safely. I still don't see any fortresses. Found 20 emeralds. We're far enough below the happiness threshold that popping the resource booster is not going to get us... not going to get us up into happy. I might be able to catch that guy as far north as he's ranging. I might be able to catch him in range of the capital. Let's go ahead and teleport back up there and attack him from that side. We might be able to get an easy kill on this army, which would be nice. Okay. So, if we're lucky... Oh, it looks like this is not a real region, because we can just barely see Green's border here. I was going to say, if we're lucky, this is a real region, and we'll be able to take control of it easily, because it won't be contested, but, no on both of those things. This is a real region. I believe they are only named if they have fortresses. Okay, that's okay. The capital has, two water tiles in it, so that's plus 6 food for the capital for the duration of the event. Alright, working on our first thingy here. It looks to me like those dudes ran off. I was hoping they would stay and try to pillage the village there. No such luck. We're not getting pillaged. Can you believe that bad luck? Okay. We just saw that ship run off here. Alright, return when we're ready to give them 100 dust. Oh, this is usually a pretty easy one. You just give them the 100 dust and then you wait a little while. And I'd love to do it for the influence. We definitely need to catch our new ship up to that ship, though. We gotta form a unified front. I'd love to do it, but I don't know how we're going to get the dust. Alright, in 2 turns we'll move forward on our faction quest. We still need to keep colonizing as well. How are you doing on food? Not that well. We need this burrow pretty badly. Yeah, it's going to gain us 9 food. I may want to move the seed storage up. We need to get seed storage going in both of our cities. Ugh, I'm in a rough place here economically. It'll all be worth it if we can just get control of a couple of sea regions. So, We can get the shipyard. The thing I'm thinking is both of our cities are still pretty clogged up as far as build goes. We have a lot of stuff we need to make. Shipyard is something I don't need to build to take advantage of, and it means that our marines could fan out and at least help us find sea ruins and fortresses and stuff. So I guess we'll just have them go to the coast and get a pearl. And get ready to fan out and contribute. We'd be able to make the dust if we devoted our cities to dust output instead of production, but I don't think that's wise. We have so many things we need to do. It would be a lot easier if we'd gotten a settle that was a little dust heavier, because then we could be building stuff and buying stuff. As it is, I think we need to make plays that are gonna... The central market really does help your... Well, how much would it cost to build a museum? 15 turns? It'd be 15 turns. Plus 20% dust in science as long as your empire's happy, plus making this city happy, is really powerful. If we were going to do that, we probably would want to make the seed storage first. Or more like, that way we can keep getting citizens born during the process. I think I'm going to go for it. This is maybe a little silly. So maybe we're not going quite as hard on the ocean stuff as I was saying earlier. We have two Fomorian Slayer ships. I don't know. I don't know if we're going to be able to pull off the comprehensive ocean control I was hoping for here. The thing is, I think we're at a point where honestly committing harder to the ocean might be a bad idea. All right, we got the Deep Divider and the Winter Shelters. We have to like fight off a really easy army, but I want to send units over here so that we can initiate combat, because otherwise they're going to slow siege that city. So should I just attack this fortress? I think so. I'd love to do the quest, but I don't think that it's really feasible. I also... There's not like a ton of science to do on this battle. Like my ships want to start really far apart. He's going to move three... It doesn't actually matter whether we get to attack him first or not, but... Oh, okay, one shot. Fine. Okay, I'll take that. Oh, this is a coast. Very interesting. Alright, so when you find a fortress in a region, it reveals... When you control a fortress in a region, it reveals another fortress in that region if you can't see them all. So that was worth it, I think, to maybe be able to get us control of Dillard before anybody else can stop us. And we only took 20 damage. Alright, yeah, we're going to have to fight this guy no matter what. This should be pretty straightforward, but let's manual it just to make sure that our marines don't get murdered. Alright, you guys, stay put for a turn. Let the battle begin to unfold. Okay, easy enough. The AI loves to position your units in kind of a silly way, and I was really concerned that it was going to just put my marines adjacent to each other within reach of the monster, and have them both get hit. Interesting, he's injured. Maybe he's retreated from something? One, two, three, yeah. Wow, we took 57 that time. That potentially bodes ill for our ability to take this other fortress by force. We got shipyard a lot more quickly than we often do. So we actually could settle across the ocean here. Okay, I don't remember how many fights are involved in this step of our faction quest. Okay, produce at least 40 food in one of your cities for 10 turns for some influence. That's fine. So we can walk to here, teleport. This should also be pretty easy. Again, it's really important, though, that we don't get hit unnecessarily with our ranged units. So he's going to move up. I want to spread out. Where do I think he's going to go? He's going to go here or here. So I need to move into a location. Eh, you know what? Just shoot. He's going to get to our archers. There's not really a way to stop a fast flying unit. Or he's not particularly fast, but a flying unit. Oof. Okay, it hurt, but nobody died. Okay, apparently that was it. So we got our winter shelters, which are fine. Build the winter shelters in the capital. Okay. Well, that's something that's going to have to wait, obviously. Alright, so we're producing enough food now. We're going to have some births. This is going to be a lot of turns, but the payout of having it is tremendous. Oh, I suppose I should research something. Good call, game. So, what's next? Probably it should be... We're going to actually have resources to upgrade our troops. Let's get ready to take advantage of that. And hopefully these guys want to give me like a really easy quest. A really easy, very accomplishable quest. No, but they do want to have three ships here so that we can't, Your next empire plan, set economy and population to the level 1 minimum and don't put anything into military. That's actually totally doable, and the next empire plan is in 3 turns. So we should turn around, I think. I don't know if this is a 2 or 3 fortress region. It's possible that it's 3, and if it is 3, we can see this whole border. So if it is 3, the last fortress will be this way, and we need to be in that area already. Alright, somebody's got 30 units. That's a bummer. Oh, and we lost our teleport ability. What a bummer, man. We're not going to be able to, we're not going to be able to pop the booster again for a while. It's going to be a long time until the next winter. It's okay. We'll just walk to the coast. Alright, so this region has Silix. Actually, do I just want to send us across the ocean to explore this? I was thinking we could go up here and try to check the sea region out and find fortresses and stuff. But maybe it would be better for my land armies to just go over to here and see what we can see. Actually, it's probably better for us to split up, but I don't know if I want to take the dust hit from running the additional army. Alright, so Lais is working on stuff. We're actually going to have a berth. Next turn. Yeah, this is going slower than I would have liked, but honestly, I think we're getting there. Alright. If we can take over the C region, it would be a big deal, because it would mean we have a really great source of adamantium early in the game. Okay, this is also a border. Interesting. This might be a two-fortress region, which means we might actually get control of it. Controlling the sea region is important for a number of reasons, but the most important one is that it makes it hard for the computer to take it from you. Neutrals can still take it from you. Take control of a bastion in Aldodev. Well, it revealed the location of a fortress. I don't feel too bad about that. You guys need to not be in a lightning storm, preferably. Okay. This quest was economy and population. Okay, it's the same as the, sadly, we can't do that. I think this is worth it for control of that fortress. Okay, food production is back to normal in the water, but Hyloman now has a seed storage plant, so we can at least continue to grow. Alright, let's see if we have turned the region to our control. Could be another fortress up here. Nope, we got it. We're gonna have to deal with these minor faction navies trying to destroy it because they live for destruction. We got 25 spices out of that as well, which we will definitely use immediately. Wait a minute. Huh. Somebody's got at least three, but nobody's gotten this yet. If we can get... It says luxury boosters, right? Yeah, okay, our faction thing doesn't count. We have enough emeralds to pop the emerald booster. It doesn't really do anything for us, but if we got... If we could find the materials for one more booster, we could get all that gold. So this is not great. The Wandering Navies are three units with advanced naval units, which means we need to produce boats again, or else we're going to lose control of this pretty quickly. I think I definitely want to build that burrow. This burrow is not even approval negative, because we're expanding into a plus approval anomaly. So this is pretty fantastic. Alright. Yeah, we need more ships, man. We need, like, a lot more ships. We need to build... Once we have this burrow up, I'm gonna build a settler in Lais. I know that the population is low, but... I think it's worthwhile. So now, we have a couple of questions. Number one is, what is the next research? I think at this point we should pick up Alchemy Workshop. We're gonna actually be able to build them shortly. And... Do I want to change my holy resource to glass steel for a while? We have a lot of things we need to do. We need to buy governors. We need to pump out ships. I think we really do need a dust boost. Like, pretty badly. Alright, plus 17 is not terrible. And just to be sure. Yes, that did not count as a third booster. Okay. Our approval level is low enough that popping the emeralds won't move us up on that. Alright, so I think actually Valdea may be the next region we settle. We can get that wine. And then if nobody else has achieved that legendary deed by then, we get the wine, immediately use it, and then... oh no, it's only going to be 15 wine and we'll have 3 cities by then. Yeah, this sucks. We can't... I don't think we can hold this fortress. Because we have to fight them. We can't run away. They'll break the fortress. We need it. We're also getting a little bit of grass silk now. in 14 turns. Oh no, we're getting 1.5 from the fortress. Oh right, because we're getting extra because we control the whole region. So it won't be that many turns before we have 15 grass silk. We can then pop grass silk and emeralds for the booster. Yeah, they're gonna destroy us, right? We can hold the fortress for an extra turn or two by doing a retreat here and then just staying put, and they'll keep attacking us instead of the fortress, I think. But, I mean, this is, there's no way for us to keep this navy from breaking our control. We can take it back afterward if we start building naval units once we get the wonder done, but that is our best case scenario, is we lose this and get it back. So the question is, do I run the ships away, in which case they break our control of the fortress, or do I retreat these ships over and over again? I can do that for 3 turns. This guy will die right now, but this guy will go to half health, and then he'll heal to slightly more than half, and then lose half health again. And that would allow us to keep the fortress guaranteed for 3 more turns. It's 3 more turns of us getting adamantium and, of course, getting the science and influence boosts from controlling stuff. It also means that our troops are more likely to get across the ocean safely, because these dudes are distracted. Yeah, we're gonna retreat in place. Actually, I wonder if I could, I wonder if I could get them to follow us away. If I move to a spot that's just slightly out of their reach. I should have gone down this way first. I wonder if I can get them to chase us but not actually be able to fight us. They'll be able to catch up to us this turn. I can actually use the Marines to keep pushing that. Okay, you're not involved. You retreat. So we see green's border and blue's border. Okay, blue is ardent mages. We can actually use the Marines to draw them off, I think. We might be able to keep them from sacking this fortress for quite a while. We really need more ships, though. Because this army's got to have 3 move because of the artillery ship. Yeah, I wonder if we can draw them off. If we move very quickly at the beginning of the turn, they won't be able to reach us. So let's see if they try or if they just sack the fortress. No, they're going for us. Okay, we can draw them off. This is good. Let's try to make landfall quickly. Actually, probably not. They're not going to be able to chase us. What am I thinking? Well, we are 4 turns off of that. We need to settle out across these regions relatively quickly. You don't want to have 2 cities at turn 44. It's not totally ideal. Okay, winter is quite far away, so we're not going to get that production boost for a while. Oh, I didn't dial in a path. 1, 2, 3, yeah. Okay, so they can't reach us. They can't reach us, but they should be able to see us, I think. Yeah, I want them to know where we are. I don't want them to... Oh, okay. Well, that region just turned blue. Somebody just get... Yep. What is green? Green is... We can't tell. There's no faction units here. Green is some guy who has fire ships. And that ocean region. Okay, we need to turn around. This needs to be our next focus. 3 turns off. 3 turns off of having some build time available. Ah, I can't get vision of them back. Well, I know they're right here. So they can move to right here. You know, nobody ever messages me on Steam. This is crazy. Nobody ever messages me on Steam. The second I sit down to start recording, all of a sudden. Okay. So if we see the faction, the neutral navy start moving, we want to start moving too. Oh, they're moving the wrong way. Actually, maybe green will fight them for us. Looks like that's exactly what's going to happen. And green can't break our control of the region. That was, like, hugely best case scenario right there. Okay, well, I feel like we're pretty secure now. Okay, we see the red Morgar. We knew that already, of course, because we set them as Morgar at the beginning of the game. Okay, so we're going to meet green in a second, once they get vision of the fortress. Ooh, that sucks. That's not good for us. Alright, it is time for settling. We really, really need settlers. How long will it take to repair this village? I kind of think we need to get these out as fast as possible. Alright, so we know where a fortress is, but we have a quest to capture it, which is going to prevent us from talking to them. And here we go, green is a vaulter. Okay. Howdy. So it's not impossible that we could get this region as well. If we did, that would be incredible. Absolutely fantastic for us. I don't know how likely it is, but... Alright. What else do we need? We need industry. Worse in this game than I think in most games. Pretty badly. We're definitely having some industry problems and dust problems at the same time, and that's a bad pair of problems to have. We're just bad at producing things and making stuff. Surely there will be no huge consequences for this. Now, this is a single vor, but it's level 4. Hi, Green, what's happening? Maybe you could go away. Okay, we got it. So I'm assuming that this is, Oh, somebody took control of a dust accumulator. Well, that's crappy timing. We were just about to have an explosion of effectiveness. Well, as you can see, it has not adjusted our approval ratings correctly in the UI, because 65% should be happy. So we may not actually be losing one dust per turn. Let's wait and see what that number looks like next turn. Alright, it's time to upgrade the boarding vessels. Let's give them... So you'll notice that upgrading the boarding spikes does not directly upgrade their damage. What it does is upgrade the percent of remaining life that is converted to bonus damage. But maybe we should just switch them to satchel charges. Gives them the stun capacity at a pretty low chance, but it does give actual damage as well. Now that we're a little better at building stuff, we can make a fancier ship. So this is 40% of remaining life to bonus damage. So for the first attack, that's going to be in the high 30s. So the first attack is going to be like 70-ish, more than 70 damage. Yeah, you know what? The boarding spikes might still be right. There's a difference of 13 attack and 10% on the conversion. Honestly, I don't know if it's worth upgrading them to use strategics. Given how pressed we are, we'll go ahead and upgrade the design to have plating though. Oh, it's not that somebody just took the dust accumulator, it's that the dust accumulator was just revealed by somebody moving into the next era. Okay, so what are we looking at? We're looking at 6 turns on that build? Really? That's crazy. Well, let's get our science going, and, man, everything is very expensive right now. We need more ships to try to wrestle control of this away from the other players. Blue took that factory that we can see. Maybe we don't need more ships. Maybe I should just seed the fact that we're not going to be able to control this ocean region. Before it gets controlled, I mean. Focus on infrastructure, and then after it gets properly taken over, come in and fight for it. With, like, actual fire ships and stuff. This is a decision point. We gotta make a decision. We're picking a path that is going to affect very much the way the rest of this game plays out. You know what? We just hit an hour. I'm gonna think about it. That's it for today. Come back next time. We're going to have made some kind of decision about how much we're devoting to this ocean region. And then we're gonna take over the world. And we'll see you then.